Hi, welcome to the live stream. I hope you will enjoy the show. My name is Jacqueline Boerma of the Boerma Institute. Maybe you already know. We are going to do some Christmas decorations today. And I found a very nice branch. Well, actually, it's a piece of wood with some ivy on top of that. It was strangled around the stem. So I'm going to make an arrangement in that. So everybody, welcome. I'm going to use some abies, some Christmas tree. And I'm going to use this in groups. I have a nice round container. It will be showing a little bit, not too much, just a little bit. And I'm using some Oasis biodegradable foam. Just a couple. Well, actually, oh, I forgot one. Could somebody please get some from the sink? I forgot my Oasis. I have a little piece left over in the sink. Thank you, Mike. Here you go. Thank you. There. It fits in perfectly. Cut a little bit off the Oasis, so it's a little bit more round. Hey, Ton. Ton just came in. He's early today. Are you going to have a drink? So I'm using some conifer in a group. And I'm keeping it quite simple with this arrangement. I love the branch. So what do you think? It's beautiful, eh? So I'm using that as my main center. Some conifer. A little bit more, different type. We've got our first question or remark.
We have some people saying hello in the chat.
Oh, nice.
We have Timmy Huskinson saying good morning.
Good morning, Timmy. Good morning. Thank you very much for watching.
Kim Otto, hello everyone.
Hi, goedemiddag Kim. Leuk dat je er weer bij bent.
Lisa Florissa saying hi and saying that branch, wow.
Yeah, it's beautiful, Elisa. Thank you for watching.
And we have Angela.
Hi, Angela.
And Angela says, looking good, Jacqueline.
Oh, thank you, dear. Now I can still turn my arrangement around. It's not too difficult this time, this one. I love also the way that the stem, the trunk is still growing. So you see a little bit of green here, a little bit yellow green, and here some very small leaf. It's still trying to survive, even though it is being killed. Yes.
So we have a question from, I see you changed your name. It's not Amy anymore. It says Taiwan.
Oh, nice.
That's really nice.
Hello, Wenyu. Hello, Amy. Hello, all the rest of the guys. And teachers and students from Taiwan.
Well, Taiwan has a question.
Yes.
And it says, may I ask what the topic of the design is? Dutch garden?
Yeah, more or less, probably, yes. Because I love my Dutch gardens. So, but this is going to be an arrangement for the window display. So it's a little bit linear, a little bit Dutch garden. Probably, I cannot do an arrangement without a Dutch garden, I think. Something like that. So I'm filling the base a little bit first, and then I'm going to use my higher points. I also have, we have some beautiful branches this week. Last week I went to another part of Holland, South Holland actually, and there is one of our students, and she has done the advanced course, the professional course and the advanced course, and she has a very nice, she knows a very nice gardener, his name is Jan, and Jan supplied us with most of the greens that we are using today. So thank you very much, Jan. We love your greens and branches. So one side of the arrangement will be more green, and the other part I keep a little bit open, so it is a little bit more visible. I like to show a little bit of the color of the container, because it's red, it's dark red. Yeah.
Yes, Angela says, I recognize the display behind you. 2011, I think?
This one, you mean? Yeah. We did that as a, an arrangement for Christmas, as a workshop. But I also made it for Special Bloemschikken, the Dutch magazine for hobby florist. And I thought we could get it from the back. Angelica is cleaning there again, so we found some stuff that we are going to reuse. So, thank you for watching. I was thinking this morning, well, sometimes I think, you know. So I was thinking that it's really an honor that you are, that you are looking to this live streams all the time. So, yeah, we have to do with live streams nowadays. Gets me even emotional, you know. So, gone. Clean my table a little bit. Cleaning gets you down to earth. Yeah, Angelica.
Yes, Dunja Marse is saying hello, my sweet ones.
Hi, Dunja. Thank you for watching. I'm glad that you went for an echo this morning. And that, that it's an ontsteking and not anything bad. So it still hurts, of course. But, you know, it's not, with a little bit more rest, you will be able to come and work again and join us. I hope before Christmas, though. Yeah.
Angela has a question. She says, are you still able to teach at the school, or are you locked down like us?
No, we are not locked down. We are still open. The restaurants are locked down, but we are a school, and schools can still teach. So we're very lucky with that. I was thinking maybe I could use some Ami. Yes, I'm sniffing, but that was because I was emotional before, you know. Don't have a cold yet. Yeah.
Timmy Huskinson says, the honor is ours, Jacqueline, to be here. Warm thanks.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah.
Angela says, Dunja, I hear your little pumpkin died. Oh, I hope you get better soon also.
Well, the pumpkin died, that's official. Dunja is having another car at this moment.
Oh, I saw what kind of car it was.
Yeah, and it's a very nice car.
Beautiful silver car. I think we should call it Silver Fox.
Oh yeah, that's a good name. But I don't recognize the car when she's driving. The little pumpkin I could recognize, but this one, I don't. So I'm using some moss also, because otherwise I go too high in my arrangement and I still want to see the nice parts of wood. The mic is on the front, so sometimes I get the microphone, not my mic, but mic gets, sometimes I get stuck with the little door here. Oh, that was a glass one. Nee, het is Dylan. It's dill. It's it looks a little bit like Angelica, but Angelica doesn't smell like dill. So it's actually it is dill. This material.
It's true. I smell better.
Yeah. It's sorry. You smell what? No. Yes. Didn't hear that completely, but. Oh yeah, yeah. Although this makes well. This makes you want to eat. don't go there. So some Christmas ornaments in there. Yeah.
Angela says that it looks very Japanese at the moment.
Oh yeah. Oh, but it won't for long, Angela. But it looks nice Japanese because of the branch, and also the pine tree here is also very Japanese. They use it for New Year's Eve, not for Christmas, but for New Year, for the New Year decorations. Oh, I still have a lot to fill. What can I use? Maybe some more. Christmas tree. Yeah.
Kees Tak is saying hello.
Oh, hi Kees. Leuk dat je ook kijkt. Dankjewel. I don't know. I start sniffing. Maybe it's because of I'm allergic to the camera. That's possible. Could use some more moss maybe. Yep. There. Nee, ik heb hoor. I came prepared a little bit. If I don't drop my balls. Oh yeah, smile. Yes. Yes. I'm so concentrated that I'm concentrating on my arrangement, I forget to smile. But I enjoy though. So I make a hairpin for the moss, the flat moss that I'm using. I have used the bulb moss, but the bulb moss I used with a 0.9 wire and a 1.0 wire around it. So I did not stick the hairpins in, but I wired it. So it's more compact and it's also more secure. I have glued some Christmas balls on wire. Sorry, on sticks, of course. Yeah.
We have Barry van Boven saying, awesome design, love the branch, and just like the video, almost forgot.
Oh, thank you very much, Barry. Thank you for watching also.
And we have Kees Tak saying, zat net nog naar Flower Circus te kijken. Ze zijn ook online.
Oh, Flower Circus online. Oh, that's nice. But stay here. Stay here. I'm using some bigger Christmas balls and some smaller ones, different tones. So it is more interesting to look at. The glue came off, probably. Oh yeah. Why is it not working? Because I'm putting it towards the branch. So. There you go. So these are wired on two wires. And some of them are just using some wood sticks. Yeah.
We have Max K saying hi all.
Hi Max, thank you for watching also.
And we have Ionella saying hi everyone.
Oh, hi Ionella, thank you.
And we have Shaida saying goedemiddag allemaal en mooi Jacqueline.
Hoi Shaida, leuk dat je kijkt. Dankjewel. So what is Jake is also in the house. I also have a peak, the top of the Christmas tree that we do here. We don't have a star in the tree, but we have a well, we call it a peak. How do we call it in English? How would you call it in English? I don't know. And I found these last year in a shop. And these are Christmas balls that I bought also when I was 17. So this one with the gold on top. Those are also very... a little bit aged balls. Retro. Yeah, that's a good thing. It's a retro ball. Yeah, nice. Is my sound okay? Do I need to talk louder or a little bit more soft? And actually also reusing some Christmas balls that we used last year. We stocked them. And now we can reuse them again. Well, actually, we can reuse them. We can use them again. This one is a little bit off there. Yeah.
So the sound is all good.
Okay, thank you. Where shall I put it? Maybe not. No. That's too much, too close to the same color of... So I'll use this one here. Yep. And I'm not going to use that one there. So, then it's almost ready. And last year, Ton got something nice from a friend for Christmas. And that's this little guy. So I was thinking to use that because it's a window display. And guess where it will be? Well, in my window. So I'm using something from my house. And this one is... Elf on the Shelf, probably. And we call it a nar. So it's also a little bit from Ton, a little bit narrig. Yeah, oh, it's a joker, yes. Yeah, so he will sit, well, before he could sit on this one. Yeah. Now he gets a little bit stuck. So... There he is. So this one is for some kind of glue, rashes. So this is my Christmas window display, and we'll take a photo from it up close, and then you can see it maybe a little bit better. Are there any questions about this arrangement? Yeah, good.
Angela says, I think it's a smiley face with a sunglasses. So I think it's a smiley face that's like saying cool.
Nice.
And Sibel says, heel mooi, Jacqueline.
Dankjewel.
And Angela says, beautiful.
Well, thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Well, actually, we need Axel for this part, because we're going to take this one away, and then we're going to use the other, we're going to display the other one. I also, because it's a little bit big, so it needs to be with two guys, preferably, because we ladies are so, you know,
delicate.
Delicate, yes. Zeg het maar.
Lisa says that the piece is very nice. Max K is also sending a cool emoji with a, I think, a little guy holding a flower.
Thank you.
Timmy says, love it. That's a long name. Jacqueline and Jimenez says, muy bello, gracias por compartir su talento. That's my best I can do.
Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias. Okay, so this was my color. I'm going to continue with the next arrangement. Oh yeah, that was a Christmas ball that was already dead. That's okay. Okay, thank you guys. So, cleaning up very fast. We're going to continue with the next arrangement. I used four candles because, well, you know, it was a nice dividing. It's it could be an Advent arrangement, could also be just a Christmas arrangement, or it even could be a Hanukkah arrangement. I'm going to use natural things. This piece of wood I used a couple of years ago at the IPM in Essen for a demonstration on stage. Of the FDF stage, and we were together there with the International Teachers of Floristry and Gregor Lesch. So I kept this piece, of course. It was made in a different direction. It was used vertical. Now I'm going to use it horizontal, and I'm going to fill it a little bit more with some materials. Where did I put that? Yeah. I used a couple of these, this oasis garland inside, and I also used some oasis biodegradable foam and an oasis double tray underneath this one, and here I stuffed the garland. So yeah.
First of all, Angela says, delicate, cheeky.
Yeah, and, we are very delicate. Yeah.
And about the wood, she says, wow.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Huh? It has been outside, so it has been aging a little bit. But something that's aging, you don't necessarily need to throw away immediately. Yeah.
Timmy says, I love it already. And a question from Angela.
Yeah.
Have you screwed the bark together?
No. No, I sometimes screw up things, but no, I did not. This is a natural piece of wood. So it just came like this. The only thing that I added was the container underneath. And then I taped that. Together with the wood. So I didn't do anything about the wood itself. It came in naturally. So I'm using some cupresses. Some of the, you know, they grow in Greece. the one that Mike used last week, you know, the... Can I? Yes. The little thingies that he used last week in his arrangement. Where shall I put this one? Maybe just there. And I'm going to fill it in with some natural materials. And it might be a little bit too high. Sorry? Gaat het, jongens? Okay.
So Lisa says amazing, and she can't wait to see what you create.
Oh, thank you, Lisa. I'm going to use a little bit more natural arrangement with this. Later on, I will also use some more of the colored ones. Actually, I'm going to get a little bit in trouble here. Very delicate, ladies. So. Yeah, that's the right direction. And I think I like to have these ones here. Yeah, go ahead.
Yes, about the previous arrangement you made, Ionella says, my seven-year-old son recognized the dill. All summer, we had a full garden of them.
Yeah.
And we like your Christmas tree, very colorful.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I thought this year I would do a little bit different. Normally, I don't use that much color in the Christmas trees, but every year we try to do something different. So this year we even used... colorful lights in there, so is it in the way? Thank you. Yeah, I used also some hippiastrum. I drilled some holes in the wood to get some more grip.
Angela says, in England, we laugh when four candles are mentioned. Watch the two Ronnies. Funny sketch about four candles.
Okay, the two Ronnies. Okay, I'll remember that.
Oh, and she says, your Christmas tree is a typical English one.
Really? Oh, dear. Well, as long as you like all the colors, well, whatever you use and it makes you happy, be sure that you use it, because it's a time that we need some more happiness. Also still have some pine tree.
Angela says sorry.
don't be. It's fun. Everybody has their own tradition, so it's whatever you like. You know. I had to get used to these kinds of colors before, But, you know, I can also have some glitter and some other things. It's okay with me. I like a lot of things. I don't necessarily need to have them in my house, but I love the colors. But for me, we bought these lights last year, Ton and I, because we have a grandson, and we thought he would like the lights. And then everything was in the color of the dark red and the Bordeaux. And then we thought the lights would fit because it would, yeah, attract his attention. And then we put them around the window. And then after 2 hours, we said, no, we have to take it off. So we started disassemble again. And then, I bought them, so I want to use them. So this year, I think we're okay with that.
Well, it works with this Christmas tree because of the colors in the tree. So yeah. I think it depends on the combination you put it with. Flamboyant.
Yeah, flamboyant. I should have finished the front of the arrangement a little bit before I do this, because I cannot turn it that well.
First, Kim Otto says, don't be sorry, Angela. Everyone has a different taste.
Exactly. There's something for everybody.
And a question from Taiwan.
Yeah.
What is the name of the branches on the right and the left end?
Oh, those are magnolia branches. Beautiful, eh? They're also from Jan. Move a little bit out of the way. I use some elfenbankjes. Weet het even niet in het Engels. Mushrooms? Okay, kind of mushrooms. It's a kind of mushroom. Yeah. It should go together with my other arrangement before. Then I had a kind of elf in there. Yeah, zeg het maar.
Max K has a question.
Yes.
How are the bulbs holding? I didn't see the sticks.
Oh, well, here you see two little wires. So I drilled two holes and I actually drilled them a little bit too big. So I used some glue and then you just stuff them on there. I'm using some lycodendron. Is that a question?
Yes, question from Angela. I have the mushrooms. How did you wire them?
Oh, I bought them wired. At the wholesale, yes. Yes, really. You can see the box.
Because we have them without wire too.
Yeah, well, I thought it would be easy. Yeah, you could wire them. They are very soft, so you could make a hole in it.
As I remember, the mushrooms we have in the back without the wire, I think we just took the 1.8 wire or the 2.0 one and just stabbed the mushroom with it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like twisting in it.
Yeah, you could wire them on different ways. But something like that, it would work.
Or hot glue.
Hot glue is fine. And actually these mushrooms are wired on one leg. You see a silver wire there. So it would be easier if you have them on two wires, because if you have them on two wires, they don't twist around. Then I have some beautiful eryngium. I have used that in groups and I will use that here also a little bit more. It goes very nice with the gray of the cupresses, and it also goes with the pine tree. So just need to fill a little bit more. And then I have some beautiful clematis. Clematis, it's a new kind. Tomorrow, no, actually, on Monday, it will be available at the flower auction in Aalsmeer. It's called Amazing Vienna, of course, it's amazing. So it should be the name, should have the name Amazing. Amazing Vienna from Marginpar, of course. Marginpar has beautiful flowers, and they import the flowers, and also a lot of summer flowers all year round. Let's see. It's not so handy. Yes. These flowers, like the delphinium and the clematis. The clematis Amazing Vienna comes from Marginpar. So look at this color. It's amazing, right? It's also amazing. So it's beautiful. So I'm using a little bit of
okay, I think it's back now. Yeah.
Thank you.
I'll shoot.
Well, I'm adding some delphinium. That's what I said. And I'm also still adding a little bit more of the very interesting clematis. Yeah, I'm also making this arrangement a little bit for Karel, because Karel's favorite color is blue. So Karel, this one is a little bit for you. Yeah, I said that it's also a little bit for, it could be for Hanukkah. For Christmas, it would be a little bit easy, a little bit early, I mean, because I'm using these fresh flowers. But it's nice to use a little bit fresh flowers. If you do it later in the season, a little bit like a couple of days before Christmas or Hanukkah, then you could still keep it for the days. I'm also using some nice, beautiful blue ones from Marginpar. Yep, there. So it floats over into the nice stems of the magnolia. Little bit blue on this side. Yep. And I have some dried flowers, some dried hydrangea from Peter Kolk. But I forgot to put my, well, actually we moved things, so I have to put on the glue gun for that. Are there no questions? It's quiet?
Just thumbs up.
Oh, a thumbs up. Oh, that's good. So people are still watching. Yeah, I wish I could reach there. Zie ik dat? Waar zie ik? Zie jij nog oasis? Do you still see oasis? Probably there. En naast de distel. Ja, there's a, hoe heet zo'n ding? Een gleuf in het Nederlands. There's a little opening. So I cannot see it on the camera, but Mike is helping me to find the holes. Oh my. I'm dancing around my arrangement. Some pine cones also helps with the Christmas feeling. And I still need some green there, because otherwise I see a lot of oasis. Oh, this is so nice. Oh, I planted it in my other arrangement. This is such a nice Christmas tree. Thank you. Yeah, I don't need that bag anymore. I already have my tools with me.
Is that green one also from Jan?
Yeah, that's also from Jan. Yeah,
it's
nice,
beautiful. Yeah? I saw beautiful, it outside.
Huh? Yeah, just a couple of branches, but this is the most beautiful Christmas tree part. So I don't want to destroy this thing, because here I can still use that. Uppata. So, and some moss and some little pine cones. They were already wired, but we didn't buy them. We used them on, we put them on wire before. Yeah.
Ionella says, we are speechless, oh. Big like.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. There. Just some green, so you have a little bit more depth in there. Take this one out. Put this one there, and then put that one on top. Yeah, like that. Because then I also, I think I covered my tape. The one with where I moved, where I got my oasis stuck on the, a little bit dark here, maybe. Maybe some little pine cones. Those are, they call them shaved pine cones. Geraspt. Geraspte dennenappels. Little bit difficult word. Yeah.
Question from Angela. Did you use one tray or of oasis or many blocks?
I actually used two whole blocks. I used two blocks because it's in the double block tray there, and I used a piece, well, I think 2.5. I used a piece of Oasis here, and then I used the Oasis garlands. Yes.
Lisa says the flowers in Holland are so strong and beautiful. That clematis, wow.
Oh yes, it's beautiful, eh? And it also can come to England and United States and everywhere because they ship it everywhere.
When I was working in Florida for Taylor Twick, they also had Martin Parr's clematis and a couple of other varieties. So do you know a couple of exporters that are exporting there by name?
Yes, Hilverda de Boer. Hilverda de Boer exports to United States. And also, I have to check who else does. But at the flower auction, they do that. So, yeah. That's nice. I think it's good that it's not really hot glue. Because I touched my... Goedemorgen. Fine. Yeah, it's not hot. So I think I will leave this part of design for what it is at this moment. The last bits I will fill in with before the photo is taken, because that takes me a lot of hassle to go around and to be in the front. But you can see that I use the white of the candles. It comes back into the beautiful, amazing Vienna. The white clematis, and I also the blue comes back a little bit in the blue clematis, so my colors come back on my arrangement. So we're going to do a little trick again, but we need, I think, Axel again for that.
Angela loves it.
Thank you, Angela. Sometimes I wish my tools would do what I would want them to do. So this one is moving out of the way. Nee, niet tillen, gewoon de hele kar weg.
Oh, oké.
Okay. Ja, die gaat erheen.
Alright.
Ja.
Even die lamp.
Ja. Bye bye arrangement.
Taiwan says it is amazing.
Thank you Amy, and thank you and you. Yep. The next arrangement.
Mall renovation guy, sorry.
yep. It fits my Christmas tree. So I found a wall decoration part in a garden center. And it's round. Well, maybe Mike can take a photo from it from the top. I put it on a big container. And the container was silver color before. But now it is spray painted gold to match the wall decoration. And I thought the wall decoration needed a bit of color. So I'm using Christmas balls. Also from the same garden center. And then I have used Oasis underneath it, the Oasis foam. And then I use some moss to fill the holes a little bit. And this is going to be on a side table. So it's not going to be on a high table, but you actually can see on it. Yeah.
Yes, Max K says super, wow, so colorful.
Yeah. It's a little bit over the top colorful, I think. Yeah.
And Jacqueline and Jimena says bellissimo.
Muchas gracias.
And Angela says, thank you for doing these demos. When you can't play with flowers, this is the highlight of my week.
Oh, thank you, Angela. So thank you very much for hearing, for telling that. So a little bit pine tree here. And some other branches. It doesn't need much because the balls are already over the top. I'm using just a couple of greens there. And I thought it would look a little bit like a disco Christmas or something like that. Oh, sorry. Grazie mille. Grazie. Well, it sounded familiar. I've been to Italy quite some times in my youth. In my young days with my parents, I went. I learned how to surf there, windsurfing. So a little bit more green. And some red from the Ilex. And the Ilex I spray painted with some glitter. Yeah.
So Lisa says, me too, Angela. No flowers here.
No flowers?
No flowers here. She also has no flowers to play with.
Ah. Why not, Lisa? That's a pity. You should have flowers in your life. So also some candles, some more candles to go in between. There, just make sure that they are safe. I still have, oh, what is there?
Angela says, sad times, Lisa, but we have the Burma.
Yeah, and you should all come together next year. Sorry, that was maybe too loud, but yeah, I really miss you guys. You should come over again. Time. It's time. Yeah.
Ionella says, this year I was thinking to do a monochromatic Christmas.
Yeah.
But now I've changed my mind.
Thank you. I'm glad that we can inspire you to do some crazy things. I use some flowers, some carnations here in the center just to get another kind of texture in between the Christmas balls. Yeah.
Lisa says, seriously, the best part of my week. And Angela says, lockdown, Jacqueline. They can't get flowers because of the lockdown, of course.
Oh, also no flowers. Yeah. Wow. Here in Holland, during lockdown, the florist could make people happy with a lot of flowers. But I think having no flowers is really bad. Nice color, huh? I think Mike bought them. You bought them last week, huh?
Yep.
Yeah. So they opened up nicely. Yeah.
Lisa says, love the colors too, Ionella. And Angela says, inspiration from your top, perhaps?
Inspiration from your what? Sorry? Top?
You're wearing a beautiful top.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, thank you. I love my top also. It's actually something I bought a couple of years ago when I was a judge in Spain. There was a competition for, hoe heet die dingen? Van die huizen en dan de binnenkant van de tuinen. So, No, it's like a yard. They created designs for the yards. In Spain, you have houses like a hacienda. It's in a square, And then the closed in the middle, it's closed.
Binnenplaats.
So, yeah, binnenplaats.
Binnenplaats is the
yeah, anyway, I was a judge there some time ago. And then also I had the honor to meet Daniel Ost, because he also was a judge. And Thomas de Bruyne was there as a competitor.
Courtyard.
Courtyard, yes.
Thank you, Lisa.
I use some purplish carnations, sorry, gerberas in there. Just to give the, just to use some more flowers. And some taxes. And please remember that this kind of arrangement will be lower on the floor, so you can look onto it, not from the side. Yeah.
Angela says that a lot of florists have gone under.
Yeah, I can imagine that. It's terrible. Yeah, but it's not only the florist there. I think it touches everybody. We are so lucky here in Holland that we don't have a complete lockdown. I was so bold to use these the tillandsias from Mike last week from his arrangement, because it gives another kind of a texture in it. And actually, I wanted to have some of those straws. Remember, Angelica, the ones with the
yes,
the fluffy thingies.
I forgot to look for them.
We had straws with a kind of
glitter skirts.
Glitter thingies. So that would have been nice together with this. But anyway, you just imagine them. Because it has those fountain-like things. And I bought the anthuriums, but the anthuriums were a little bit too dark, actually, for my taste to go with this arrangement. I thought they would have been a little bit more pink, so I spray painted them with some glitter.
Glitter makes everything better.
Oh yeah, glitter makes everything fun. So it's a little bit like a, why doesn't it move anymore? Well, never mind. Yep.
Sue Tsung says, hey,
oh,
Diva.
Hi, Sue.
Hey, Diva, Jacqueline. So glad to be able to join again today.
Oh, thank
Looks
you.
Looks very festive. Greetings to Angelica, Mike, everyone there at the school.
Thank you very much, Sue. Nice that you are watching again. And of course some gold twigs to go in there. So I should sharpen my knife a little bit more. I think I said that last time. Those are birch trees, birch branches. Yeah, we already have them for 3 years. So finally, let's get rid of them. We'll use them this Christmas. Yeah.
Dunja says, ook de groeten van mijn ouders. So
oh,
greetings from her parents.
Dankjewel. Doe de groeten terug. They probably are coming over with you. Wat zit daar? Daar zit een metalen stukje. Make sure that I don't light my twigs. I don't need to get rid of them that much.
Light them on fire.
Let's see if I still have some holes. You know what else I forgot? Something very important. I will show you in a minute. So. And some stars. They also have some, they don't have glitter, but they have some kind of icing on them. Yeah, I shouldn't forget that. So, this is more like a tropical arrangement, I think. Oh. Later on we'll see what fell in the garbage can, right? Oh yeah. Oh. My Oasis knife. Already lost one once. Zit die dan te dicht daarbij? Let's do two together, because these little Gerberas are together. Then my little stars can be together. What else do I have? Oh, some more glitter. Of course. Nope, I don't need that. Nope, maybe this rose. Could use that somewhere. Yep. Like that. Oeh, oud en stijf, nog geen 80. I have some little other stars that twinkle. Yeah. Can you see it like that? A little bit better? Maybe. That makes it a lot easier to put it in. This is wire, Jacqueline. Yeah, thank you. Yes, please, Angelica.
Question from Angela.
Yeah.
Confused. Grouped design or scattered random?
Probably it's a scattered random. More like my feeling today. Yeah, there's some grouping, but it's random grouping. Random. So scattered random would do it nicely. But don't be confused. It's this arrangement is all over the place. So my Christmas tree is all over the place. So whatever you like to do with this. Just, I didn't want to do too much grouping because I have so many different colors of Christmas balls. I didn't want to do the grouping and I also didn't want to do the things too many through each other. So a little bit more scattered random. Angelica.
Angela says, wow. And Lisa says, spectacular, bright and fun.
Thank you.
Max K says Winter Wonderland.
Well, for me, Winter Wonderland is a little bit more white and a little bit more sober. But yeah, it's magical. It's a little bit.
It's like fairy tale Winter Wonderland.
Yeah. So, do it again. So these things that is missing is this one. Merry Christmas. Yeah, but because I turned it, I have there, Merry Christmas, not too big. Had je nog een vraag?
Well, this is really, really nice. Sue says, I just wanted to tell you this week I did my second wedding assignment. The bride came to tears when she saw the bouquet for the first time. I felt very proud to be a fellow Burma.
Oh, thank you very much. Congratulations with the results. That's very nice to hear. It's always nice when they get emotional because that makes, that gives you goosebumps. Yeah. So, and then of course this you have to imagine that this arrangement needs to be lower on the table or maybe even on the floor, so you can really sit next to that and then have a, that's why I wanted to have these. This is a glass that I bought in Italy years ago. So this is a cocktail glass. I won't move my arrangement anymore. So this is a cocktail glass. So you can have a sip of cocktail with those sparkly things and maybe even a, so wait that, fireworks a little bit, like crackers thingies. Yeah, yeah, sparkling things. And have a cocktail and that's what I forgot, you know. So, so, okay. So, thank you very much for watching. Is this okay? Well, never mind. It's crazy anyway. So, I hope you have enjoyed. And please come back again. In 14 days, we will do the last demonstration of the year. Together with, I will be together with Mike and with Karel. So we will not do Christmas, but we will do other kinds of arrangements. And I hope you will be watching again. So thank you very much. Bye bye. Bye bye. Oh, sorry, kom maar. Bye bye. Axel, yeah.
Oh, and our assistant branch manager would also like to say hello and goodbye to you guys.
Bye bye. Goed zo. Goed gedaan.